Good morning. Welcome to my channel Awesome Learning. And today's topic is human neural system. We have already finished our generation and conduction of nerve impulse part. So today we are going to start with the neural system. Okay. So as you see here, children, division of neural system. Human neural system is divided into mainly two parts. The central neural system, that is the CNS, and peripheral neural system, that is PNS. Okay. Now this is your central neural system because it runs through the center of your body, and this is your peripheral nervous system because it runs through the periphery. Periphery means onto the sides. Okay. So this is your PNS. Now, central nervous system, as I said, is in the center. So the parts that are present in the center is the brain and the spinal cord, which runs through the middle or the center of the body. And the peripheral neural system consists of two parts. One is the somatic neural system and the other one is autonomic neural system. So I hope that you should also draw this flowchart so that remembering the parts is easy when you read through a flowchart. Now let's move on with the central nervous system, that is the brain. Now children, as you have done this already in class 10th, so there will be certain new things added up to your knowledge. You see, the first point they say is it is a protected incranial cavity. So we all know that brain is as on itself very soft because it is made up of lot of neurons, white matter, gray matter, right? But this soft part of the brain is protected from outside by cranial cavity. So this is the cranial cavity which protects the brain inside. Now, it has three layered connective tissues, membranes called cranial meninges. So these are the cranial meninges, as you see, which is three layered. Now, let me show you here the layers. You can see here the three layers or the membranes which protect your brain. So the three meninges or the three layers are, the outer one is the dura mater, as you see in the diagram. The middle one is the arachnoid mater and the inner one is the pia mater. So these are the three meninges or the three layers which protect the brain from outside. Children, the subarachnoid space. Now, what is this subarachnoid space? This is a space between pia mater and arachnoid matter. That means there is a space between the inner and the middle part. A space between the inner and the middle portion of the meninges, and that space is called subarachnoid space, and this space is filled with a fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. Okay, and the ventricles of the brain are also filled with CFS, that is cerebrospinal fluid. So if the question comes in exam that where can we find the CSF or where do we find the cerebrospinal fluid, so you have to mention two places. One, cerebrospinal fluid is found in the subarachnoid space, and the second one, they are also found in the ventricles of the brain. Children, cerebrospinal fluid acts like a shock absorber if there is a certain jerk to the person, or the person falls down, or sudden you can say jerk is there to protect the brain. This cerebrospinal fluid acts as a shock absorber just to protect the brain. So I hope this point is very much clear to all of you. Now let's move on Children, brain has three divisions. We have done this in class 10, forebrain. Now, scientifically, forebrain is called prosencephalon. Okay, midbrain, mesencephalon, and hindbrain, rhombencephalon. So these are the terms, scientific terms given to forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Okay, now you know forebrain, children, this is the forebrain. You see, the major portion of the brain is actually the forebrain. You can see this whole part is the forebrain. This whole portion is the forebrain. Then comes the midbrain. This is your midbrain. Okay. This is midbrain. And then is the hindbrain. Okay. The large, last part of the brain is the hindbrain. Now, forebrain, as you see here, consists of these parts, the cerebrum. This whole part is the cerebrum. Then thalamus, this reddish part is the thalamus. And hypothalamus, you can see this hypothalamus. And you also see that along with the hypothalamus, pituitary is attached. See? Hypothalamus extends into the pituitary. So this whole portion is the forebrain. Then you see midbrain. This is your midbrain. Okay. And your hindbrain consists of pons, medulla oblongata, and your cerebellum, which is just behind. And from here, spinal cord continues. So these are the general structure of the human brain. Now let's move on to the first part of the brain, that is forebrain, also called as prosencephalon. Now you see, children, it is the anterior part. Anterior means front part, aage ka hissa, right? So it is the anterior part, and I told you it consists of cerebrum. I've shown you here cerebrum and diencephalon. Now children, diencephalon, what is diencephalon? Thalamus and hypothalamus, both of them combine together and they are called diencephalon. So these are the parts of the forebrain. Now we will study individually each part. So the first part of the forebrain is cerebrum, right? It is the cerebrum. It is the largest part of the brain. As I told you, cerebrum is the largest part and it has two hemispheres. Now, if you look at the brain upside down, it will look like this. It has two hemispheres. You can see this is the right hemisphere and this is the left hemisphere. Okay? If you see upside down, this is how the brain will look like. See? Or upar se, it will look like this. These are the two hemispheres, one, two, and upside down it will look like this. Now it has two cerebral hemispheres. Both the hemispheres are held together. You can see here, both the hemispheres are held together by a tract of nerve fibers called corpus callosum. Now isi cheez ko bada karke they have shown you here, see. So this is your right hemisphere, this is your left hemisphere, and these are the nerves which connect the two hemispheres, and this tract of nerves. Tract means rasta jahan se nerves connect karengi. These are the tract of nerve called corpus callosum, which connects both the hemispheres. Okay, so this is how cerebrum looks like. Now you see here, children, outer part of the cerebrum is called cerebral cortex. Okay, outer part of cerebrum is called cerebral cortex. It has convolutions. Convolutions means folds. Ye dekho, convolutions hai na? बीच बीच में गड्ढे, फिर उठा हुआ, फिर गड्ढा, फिर उठा हुआ, फिर गड्ढा. सो मेनी कन्वुलेशंस आर देयर, यू कैन सी हियर. दीज आर कन्वुलेशंस, दैट इज एंड डिप्रेशंस. कन्वुलेशंस मींस उठा हुआ पोर्शन एंड डिप्रेशन, यू नो, गड्ढा है ना, एंड इज फॉर्म्ड ऑफ ग्रे मैटर. So the outer portion, you see here now, this is the outer portion. Outer portion, grey color ka dikh raha hai aapko? The outer portion is called cerebral cortex. Outer portion is called cerebral cortex. It is of gray in color and it has many convolutions and depressions. Okay, gray color. Why do they have gray color? Gray color is due to the presence of neuron cell bodies. Now, children, mind it. You have to remember this. Why is the outer portion of cerebrum gray in color? Why? Because the outer portion is made up of neuron cell bodies. If you remember the structure of neuron, neuron has two parts. The head portion of the neuron is the cell body, and then there is a long axon, if you remember, right? तो जितनी भी सेल बॉडीज है यानी न्यूरॉन का जो स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट है जहां पे डेंड्राइट्स है और सेल बॉडी है जिसको हम साइटॉन भी कहते हैं सारा का सारा न्यूरॉन के जो साइटॉन्स हैं दे आर इन द आउटर पोर्शन दैट इज इन द कॉर्टेक्स एंड हेंस दे गिव बिकॉज ऑल टुगेदर सारी न्यूरॉन्स का हेड है यहाँ पे एंड टेल अंदर की तरफ है सारी न्यूरॉन्स का सेल बॉडी ऊपर है यहाँ पे और उनका जो एक्सॉन एंड है वो अंदर की तरफ है इसलिए द आउटर पोर्शन ऑफ द ब्रेन इज ग्रे इन कलर एंड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ग्रे मैटर बिकॉज ऑल द न्यूरॉन्स न्यूरॉन्स सेल बॉडीज आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस आउटर पोर्शन दैट इज द कॉर्टेक्स The inner portion of the cerebrum is the white matter. Now, why is it white? Because neurons के जो axon ends हैं, वो यहाँ पर हैं, and that is why they give white color to the inner part of the cerebrum. Okay? Now, you see, children, cerebral cortex. दिस सेरिब्रल कॉर्टेक्स जिसको हम ग्रे मैटर भी बोल रहे थे द सेरिब्रल कॉर्टेक्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ मोटर एरिया दैट इज इट कंट्रोल्स वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट ऑफ द मसल्स नाउ यू हैव स्टडीड दैट स्केलेटल मसल्स आर द मसल्स विच कंट्रोल द वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट्स द मूवमेंट्स विच वर्क ऑन आर ओन विल सो सेरिब्रल कॉर्टेक्स के पास एक एरिया है मोटर एरिया एंड दिस एरिया टेक्स केयर ऑफ ऑल द वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट्स ऑफ द मसल्स Then it also has a sensory area that is somatosensitive area which controls the functioning of the sense organs that is your nose, your ear, your taste, your eyes. This area controls the functioning of the sense organs. Okay? Then there is an association area. Now it is neither clearly sensory nor motor. ओके ऐसा नहीं है कि जैसे दिस टेक्स केयर ऑफ ओनली मोटर वॉलेंट्री मूवमेंट्स दिस टेक्स केयर ऑफ ओनली सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स बट दिस एरिया इज नॉट डिफाइंड कि ये सिर्फ मोटर फंक्शन ही करेगा या ये सिर्फ सेंसरी करेगा ऐसा नहीं है इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इंटर सेंसरी एसोसिएशंस मतलब मिक्सड अप एसोसिएशंस या दोनों मिलकर ऐसा कोई काम करें ऐसा कोई एसोसिएशन हो तो दैट विल बी टेकन केयर ऑफ बाय एसोसिएशन एरियाज जैसे मेमोरी है कम्युनिकेशन है तो यहाँ पर हम एक पर्टिकुलर काम के साथ नहीं चल सकते टू थ्री एसोसिएशंस मिलकर ही कोई काम करेंगी सो सच वर्क हैज बीन टेकन केयर ऑफ बाय एसोसिएशन एरिया ओके Children, then let me show you that cerebrum, integrated activities of different centers of cerebral cortex control intelligence, memory, judgment, learning, thinking and articulate speech. Children, remember this, ये जितनी भी चीजें हैं ये सब integrated activities है because learning can't be done without seeing anything or without टचिंग एनीथिंग और विदाउट टेस्टिंग एनीथिंग लर्निंग का मतलब सिर्फ ये नहीं होता कि आपने बुक लेकर रट्टा लगाया अगर एक बच्चे को ये पता चल गया है कि इस कप में गर्म पानी है और गर्म चीज को मुझे हाथ नहीं लगाना, तो उसने ये चीज लर्न करी है कैसे, उसको एक बार उसने टच किया होगा और फिर उसे याद रहेगा रह जाएगा कि अरे मुझे ध्यान रखना है कि कहीं ये गर्म तो नहीं है, तो उसने ये लर्न करा कि गर्म चीज से मैं जल सकता हूँ। फिर जजमेंट करना, तो ये अकेला तो नहीं हो सकता ना जजमेंट करना, अब उसको जज करना है कि ये कप उसको पकड़ना है या नहीं पकड़ना, राइट? तो वो कैसे जजमेंट करेगा, अंडरस्टूड? सो दीज आर ऑल इंटीग्रेटेड एक्टिविटीज, अकेले नहीं करेंगे ये काम कोई भी, तो उसके लिए डिफरेंट सेंटर्स हैं सेरिब्रल कॉर्टेक्स के जो सेरिब्रल कॉर्टेक्स कंट्रोल करता है, राइट? तो सेरिब्रम इज डन टिल हियर। नाउ चिल्ड्रन, diencephalon, let us see what is diencephalon. This is also a part of forebrain. I already told you that diencephalon has two parts, thalamus and hypothalamus. Now let me show you here thalamus. It is the structure around which the cerebrum wraps. Now children, you mind it that it is a structure. If they have this is, you see diencephalon, right thalamus, hypothalamus, लेफ्ट थैलेमस, एंड ये वो स्ट्रक्चर है जिसके चारों तरफ आप देखो सेरिब्रम है ना, ठीक है? दिस इज द थैलेमस और इसी के चारों तरफ सेरिब्रम रैप करता है। इट इज अ कोऑर्डिनेटिंग सेंटर दैट इज रिले स्टेशन फॉर सेंसरी एंड मोटर इम्पल्सिस। नाउ यू नो व्हाट आर सेंसरी एंड मोटर इम्पल्सिस, यू हैव डन दिस इन क्लास 10, कि देर आर न्यूरॉन्स विच विल टेक द मैसेजेस फ्रॉम ब्रेन टू द ऑर्गन्स एंड फ्यू न्यूरॉन्स विल टेक द मैसेजेस फ्रॉम ऑर्गन्स टू द ब्रेन। तो इन दोनों के बीच में कनेक्शन कौन करता है, कुछ होती है रिले न्यूरॉन्स, इफ यू रिमेंबर रिले, है ना, जो इन दोनों के बीच में कनेक्शंस करेंगी, तो दैट इज दीज रिले स्टेशंस आर प्रेजेंट इन द थैलेमस पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन। ओके, नाउ सी हाइपोथैलेमस, इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। हाइपोथैलेमस इज सीन बिलो द थैलेमस, यू सी दिस इज हाइपोथैलेमस, दिस इज थैलेमस, बिलो द हाइपोथैलेमस इज द हाइपोथैलेमस, एंड इट हैज, इट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गन ऑफ द बॉडी, यू कैन से इट रेगुलेट्स टेम्परेचर, थर्स्ट, हंगर, इमोशंस। It secretes hypothalamic hormones. You will study this in class 12 also, that hypothalamus releases certain hormones. हम हमेशा कहते हैं कि pituitary जो है that is the master gland, okay? But pituitary को भी control करने वाला कौन है, hypothalamus, और कैसे control करता है, by hypothalamic hormones. Remember this, this is very important. Okay, so it secretes hypothalamic hormones and these hormones actually help to control the pituitary gland. Then controls your sleep, wakefulness, blood pressure, heart rate. So this is a very important organ and let me show you, this is your hypothalamus and this is your pituitary. So hypothalamus is connected to pituitary and isi wajah se hypothalamus can control the pituitary gland also. Okay, so this is the most important part of your brain, you can say. Then children, the inner parts of cerebral hemispheres and a group of associated deep structures like amygdala, hippocampus, hypothalamus, etc., together constitute the limbic system or the limbic lobe. Now you see here, they have shown you the parts. These are the parts: amygdala, hypothalamus, hippocampus. All these three constitute, and there are others also, they constitute together to form the limbic system or the limbic lobe. And this limbic system or limbic lobe, it actually regulates your sexual behavior, okay? Motivations, emotions, excitement, pleasure, rage, fear, etc. So these behaviors are controlled by the limbic system of the cerebral hemispheres. Okay, so this is also important. So midbrain will be done in the next video. Till here we have finished our forebrain.